I have gone through periods of time of being pretty angry. There have been times where I've just said, this is really unfair. It is unfair. Why? Why on earth was it me? I was born without a femur on my left leg, and what did form kind of higher up around the hip area was a real mishmash of instability. Nothing, no ball and socket, no nothing that really stabilises there. You know, my mum and dad were told that it's likely she won't be able to walk, but I'm a little tenacious. At 14 months, they did get me fit with my first prosthetic leg. That's meant lots and lots of trips to limb specialists, limb makers over the years, had countless new limbs made as I was growing. It would have been really difficult for mum and dad. My deformity is really rare, so they had to advocate and really search for the very best treatment, best prosthetic legs. So in a way, they were really protective of me, but they did put me into mainstream school, made me go to school, made me do piano lessons like my sisters. So there was certainly that wanting me to experience life as life is. I've always considered myself to be really fortunate to grow up in the church, and it was a real bed of acceptance. I had beautiful friends and really lovely older people in the church who just looked after me or cared for me or loved me. I've been a Christian, I guess, since a young kid. I mean, that was life for us. We were always going to church and part of Sunday school and all the things that come with that. The church building was really bad, for there was nothing that was, but I was just mobile then, so I could manage places like that. So I didn't feel excluded as such. So the church was a great space for growing up for me. On my hardest days of living with a disability, there's scripture verses that I hold on to and that I have to hold on to help me get through my life. It's not always easy. So I've really taken hold of some scripture verses that are very special to me. Psalm 139, verses 14 to 16. For you created my inmost being, you knit me together in my mother's womb. It goes along to say, you know, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I know that full well. God doesn't make mistakes, so that's what I hold on to. I think people with disabilities have beautiful gifts to offer. I think my own backstory, I mean, with a disability, more so in these last few years, I can't be busy. I can't sustain the busyness of Salvo World. However, being the funeral celebrant, which I absolutely love, I find that what I can offer is sitting and journeying with people, caring for people, pastoring people. But as I've grown over the years, over and again, I've gone back to that Bible verse, and it's a realisation that I'm not a mistake, and I was made for a purpose, or made on purpose for a purpose, that I'm beautifully made, regardless of what happened. It's that's my promise. That's what I hold on to deeply.